Happy Pollinator Week. This year's Pollinator Week has been designated by the USDA and the Department of the Interior, and there are lots of events happening across the country in celebration. You can check out the link in the description to find one near you. This year for Pollinator Week, I wanted to talk about a pollinator that doesn't get enough love, flies. We often associate flies with houseflies and horseflies, but there are as many as 1 million species of flies, all in the order Diptera, though only a fraction of species have been identified. Of the 150 families in the order Diptera, at least 71 feed on flowers as adults. They visit them for the same reason as pollinators you may be familiar with. They want to eat the protein-rich pollen and sugary nectar the flower produces. And as with other pollinators, they move pollen between flowers in the process. They pollinate hundreds of flower species, if not more, including some economically important ones. The cocoa tree, Theobroma cacao, is pollinated by very small midges, so without flies, we wouldn't have chocolate. Flies have been pollinating plants for millions of years. In fact, critters like beetles and flies were important pollinators before our beloved bees had even evolved. Scientists have identified flies with specialized proboscises for drinking nectar in fossils, and a fly specimen in amber from the Mesozoic era had gymnosperm pollen clumped on it. Many plants have evolved traits specifically to attract fly pollinators. The Titan arum, or corpse flower, Amorphophallus titanum, hit headlines many times in 2016 as specimens in botanical gardens bloomed. Their famous both for their size and their putrid smell, thus the flower name corpse flower. And that smell serves a specific purpose, to attract pollinators like flies and beetles. Corpse flowers are native to rainforests in Indonesia and Borneo. But flies aren't only important pollinators in temperate and tropical areas. A 2016 study found that in the Arctic, musked flies are the dominant pollinator of mountain avens, a native flower species in the genus Dryas. These musked flies are in the same genus as houseflies. And even mosquitoes, one of mankind's enemies, though not a fly, are pollinators. Only female mosquitoes feed on mammals, while male mosquitoes drink nectar and act as pollinators. So the next time you see a fly out in the wild, don't be so quick to swat at it. It's helping keep plants healthy and reproducing. Thanks so much for watching. I hope you learned a little bit about an unloved group of pollinators. In recognition of Pollinator Week, I encourage you to get outside, plant some pollinator-friendly native plants, or even install a bee bath or a bee house. Or, if you can, donate to any of the amazing organizations supporting pollinators that are linked in the description. I'm headed to VidCon in 2 days, so my next video about Aquanaut Dr. Sylvia Earle will be up on Wednesday, June 28th. If you're going to be at VidCon, please let me know in the comments or over on Twitter. I'll see you soon. The cocoa tree, it's too early for scientific names. And yes, I know I am very shiny and sweaty. I already put powder on, so there's not much else I can do about that.